Well, okay, sometimes you have to step back and really think and say that you were actually digging a hole. Yeah, this is the wrong way. Basically, there's no real reason why I couldn't just create the wait state in here and just have the state just, you know, count down. And then find a random position, and after we have finished, then just move there. Okay, this is not the way we did it here. It's not wrong. It's just a more complex approach to it, but it's not wrong. Okay, so for that, I'm not really going to change this right now. But just know that we could just have done float wait time. And while you were waiting, wait time minus delta, if wait time, and so on. Okay, that would have been the same thing with this, without having to do. My optimization brain now actually tells me to change this, however, because this approach would have been lighter than instantiating a new state and a new state. So, yeah, let's do that, I guess. Wait time, let's do like 0.8 public float max wait time. Let's do like 0.5. This one then is going to be the exit state, and I don't want to be instancing anymore. I don't want the wait state at all. Get random position. Okay, max durations. Then on init, we also want to have a wait time. Random dot range between mean wait time and max wait time. Okay, so if wait time is less than zero, or actually if wait time is greater than zero, return true. Return false. Okay, so once this is done, okay. And once we're down here, we basically need to also redo this when we're waiting. So let's test this. We should get the exact same behavior right now. Let's hit play. Come on. Okay, we just don't have the attack state for the exit state. Okay, 1, 2, and 3. And boom, attack. Awesome. So, another thing we can do is actually check for the rotation. On the handler, we were checking for this. Let's see what's this. Is close to enemy general. Minus rotate distance. Okay, we can just do a public void handle aiming to player for this, or to enemy, I guess. Then we're first going to check for the distance between vector 3 dot distance between our own transport dot position and the player dot position. But first I want to do I kind of want to have a public float check or get distance between two points that we're going to be eliminating the z value, so we'll get more accurate results. Okay, get distance between transfer dot position and enemy dot position. Now, let's pass the rotate distance over here, just so that we can control it from the AI logic. And let's say if distance is less than the rotate distance, we always want to be looking at the enemy. So let's say handle aiming to enemy. Else, enemy dot. Okay, so enemy dot looks left, is looking left. We're always going to go the opposite of what the player is looking. Okay, then otherwise we you know what, I don't think there's ever a scenario that they just don't look at the player, but I'm not sure. We have to check, and we of course have to need to have the, yeah, that doesn't matter. Okay, and otherwise let's just do unit controller dot hand rotation. Let's just say whatever you are looking at. Unit controller target direction or direction. Okay, let's just leave it empty for now, and I'm going to go on my get random position, and even if we're waiting, I'm going to say handle aiming to enemy. Let's make a public float here, rotate distance, and I'm just going to say less than 2, which probably way too much, but we can change it from the inspector, so that will be fast to change. And he doesn't do anything. Okay, does, but yeah, he's based off where we are looking at instead of looking at us. So we did this wrong. So let's get the direction between our transform position and the enemy position. I think we did this the opposite way. We should do it like this, minus transfer dot position, and then direction dot x less than 0. You wanna look left. Let's try that. Yeah, that works fine. Perfect. Now, of course, he's just firing. He's just playing the animations on any point. So another thing we can add is we can actually stack behaviors a lot more. For example, we can do we could do an attack if close to, if it's, he's close to us, we could say attack, or no matter the distance. Let's see how we can say, now rotate distance. This is actually kind of useful to just have outside public flow, get distance from enemy. And we want to get this return, get distance from enemy. Okay, we have the handle aiming. Then in here, we can always say if float, if get distance from enemy is less than an attack distance, let's see, let's say less than 0.4, then we can just return true and he will play his attack. However, he is not going to be looking at when he's moving, that is. If we're ever getting close, he's going to start attacking us without mercy, that is. Okay, so you can see where this is going. It's just a matter of thinking about all the behaviors we want. That kind of made it pretty visceral too. Let's see what's going to happen if we actually... Okay, that worked at least. I think he's dead. Okay, cool. So, I think if you are interacting, then you should never just play the logic. So let's go inside update, and use root motion, then return. So this will always be ignored then. Then we now just have to do, we have to start adding all of these. For example, although I think this actually worked fine. Let's say get distance from enemy is less than, okay. Actually, let's do, oh, it's fine. Anyway, so yeah, I think I'd rather just do a new logic, and I'm going to say mirror player. So let's see, uh, Okay, exit. Now exit and init, I'm not going to bother with this. I always want to be playing this method. So return false. So I want to get a position close to the player. And let's see how we could do that. And then handler. Get random position. Have that. Okay. Instead of a random position now, let's do public void get position close to player. Let's write the distance. And then get around the position. Okay. First of all, I need to know the direction we have from the player. So that will be enemy. Enemy dot position minus transform dot position. Okay, bull is left or right. We're going to do direction dot x less than 0. So we're going to get the target position, and that will be your transform, the enemy's position and position. And if is left, target position, so yeah, target position equals if your left target position plus vector 3 dot right by distance, otherwise target position plus vector 3 dot left by distance. Okay, so that will be your target position. And then you have to do pathfinding to that point. And let's see how we were doing that. Oh, come on. Get a random position routine. Why do I keep forgetting things? Okay, current path. Get path from your transform position to the target position, and you have to say has move position equals true. Okay, then on the AI mirror player, let's do public float distance, or keep distance. Let's assign this to 1. Then on tick, get position close to player, keep distance, then h dot move to position delta. Clear this menu. Okay, so this will never go out of this logic. We will never go out of this logic. So the next thing we can do is we need to do is create the mirror player. Exit state, I'm not going to bother with one right now, and I'm going to drag and drop the mirror player to the current logic. Okay. And as you can see, this actually works pretty great to mirror our player. Okay, we need to set up the rotation, however. So let's also do h handle aiming to enemy. Rotate distance, I'm just going to say 10. So he's always looking at the player. So this kind of like a surrounding, which is pretty cool actually. So another thing we can do is we're actually going to add an offset. So player offset and get position close to player. Instead of a distance, we're going to be adding a vector 3 of an offset. So on the target position, we're simply going to say add the offset, but if dir.x is less than 0, then offset x simply use the opposite offset x. Okay, so MonAI mirror player, instead of keep distance, let's say target offset, and we're going to pass this. So this guy, let's split this up. So one guy can be at 1, 1, and the other guy can be at 1. At maybe 1 - 4. We need to assign it, of course. Let's hit play. Hopefully we have the correct. Okay, so that's not the way to do it because yeah, he's going crazy with the call. Yeah, he's going crazy with the calls from just the target offset, that is, eh? That's weird. That's weird, but of course the fault is on our pathfinder. But there's one simpler way to fix this, and that will be to basically raise the scale maybe to up 0.5. My guy is off. He can leave out, basically. So what's this guy? The first guy is trying to do a mirror on -1 on 1. Okay, that's not working. He's not trying to mirror us at all, and that's not going to work as well. Let's see, get position close to player. Offset and position. Okay. Let's put a breakpoint. Let's close this guy. And let's put a breakpoint here. And let's see. So offset is at 1, 0. Our direction is okay. So the offset now should be -1. Our target position now should be at, yeah, at whatever that position is, ±1. Then you're going to return a path, and you return the path of 5 nodes. And you can move. Yeah, okay, so the problem with that is that they are actually aiming at their own position. Let's ignore this for a bit. So he's always going to be adding an offset to our guy. Yeah, That's it. And yeah, we should not be making this negative. Let's see. So she's now going to try and go to the opposite way of us. Although I think we can do it like this. And it should have the same effect. Yeah, it does have the same effect. And once I pass him, he's aiming at the other position. Yeah, that's pretty fine. So let's do it like that. And let's say mirror player one, he should probably be able to go. I think he's not returning a path. That's why he is stacking there, because we're not checking if these positions are even valid. So we should be doing the same things as our random position, which means try an overlap point. And if it's a valid position, do that. And then get node. And if it's walkable, then get the path and move. So that's a encapsulate. Public void is public bool is valid path. Or not valid path, is valid position. Then we can just take, let's see, we can take this. And actually, then let's cut all of this from here, or let's copy paste it, actually, that would be better. Okay, then we're going to be passing at the target position. So we're doing all of that on here, and we're going to want to ignore this. Is valid position. Is valid position equals true. Has move position, I'm going to handle that above. Random position steps, I don't really need it. Right now, you have the current path. Okay, so this changes the target position, so we do not have a reference to it. But if we do reference target position, then anything that happens on the target position, we can access it above. So let's rename this to result, so that we are not getting confused. Okay, then in here, let's do if it's walkable. Okay, so if actually let's take it from the top, let's go down here. Is valid position, is valid position, then target position, then all of this can go up till here, up till here. So if is valid position, if result, and this on the else, if result has move position equals true. Is valid position, then reference target position. Okay. So with that, we can check for the target position, for the mirror of the target position. We could say target position bool is valid. Is valid position, target position, or reference target position. And I think we did, is it asking for a path? Yeah, we can just remove this from here and do it over here, because we now have an updated reference target position. Okay. So from that, we can also do get position close to player if is valid. Do that. Okay. Then on the case that this is not valid, we can just pass this and then you can just say, tell him, you know, bool has position. So if you do not, if this is not true, go to random or attack or whatever. Okay, we're not going to worry on that. So let's hit play and let's see if that's actually going to work. And yeah, they kinda do. I don't know where those debuggers, oh, I know where those are coming from. Get position. Or inside this valid position, let's remove debugged array and debugged array. Okay, so this guy is actually going way to hell. I don't know why he's doing that. But that should definitely have not been the case. And let's maybe do 0.4. That's weird. Let's put both on 0. Okay, so they are walking, they are doing things, but I think the when it overshoots, finding a position close to us or finding a position close to the working grid or the working layer is what's actually the problem here. That's why they are sometimes not working. Let's see, maybe 0.2. Yeah, like this now works because it's a smaller position. So let's maybe tell him to go minus 0.4. Well, that seems to work fine. Okay. Let's do 0.3, 0.4. And of course, we can expand a lot more on this logic as well. You can have them interchanging those behaviors. But yeah, you can see that at least this works. Awesome. So let's finish this part here because we wanted to do a mirror, of course. And obviously, we can also do the same thing as the get random point, which is if the check distance is ever lower than that, we can say you can return true and then on exit h.assign state exit state, and that will work as well. And for assign state, yeah, okay, let's use attack. Attack or mirror player, both mirror players, let's use attack. The only issue with that is that they're basically going to leave the mirror state, and they're going to go to the random position. As you can see, this guy now is going at random positions around us. But yeah, what can we do? So it's basically just fixing up all the logic per character. The beat-em-ups are not really that deep in logic. They usually, all the enemies only do one thing, and even if we wanted to, we don't have that many animations for them to be able to do a lot of things either way. Okay, so I think we are kind of fine for now for this. So let's finish the part here. And but I think that's actually started to be pretty lovely already. So let's end the part here. And as always, I'll see you on the next one. Keep continuing supporting me on Patreon so we can make all of these nice things. So yeah, see you on the next one.